Hello and welcome all. So let us start. Today's topic is factors on which the resistance of a conductor depends. This is a topic of the electric current of class 10th. Okay. So in the last class we had discussed about the Ohm's law, and today we are going to discuss the factors on which the resistance of a conductor depends. So let us continue. In this I had written something. Let us read it first. From the experiment it was known that resistance of a conductor or insulator depends on the following factors. The factors are as follows. First, the length of the wire, cross-sectional area of the wire, the nature of the material, and the temperature. Okay, something I had written here. The temperature, this is not in our syllabus. Okay, the temperature dependence of the resistance of the conductor is not going to be discussed in our class 10th. It is of class 12 topic. But after finishing our syllabus, if I'll find it important, then I'll discuss it, but not now. Okay. So basically, these three dependencies we are going to discuss right now. So precisely, we can say resistance of a conductor is directly proportional to the length and inversely proportional to its cross-sectional area. These are very easy thing to understand. It means if the length of the conductor varies, it means say increases, then resistance will also increase. If the length decreases, then resistance will also decrease. Similarly, not similarly, sorry. It means unlikely. The cross-sectional area, it means cross-sectional area will increase, then resistance will decrease. If the cross-sectional area will decrease, then resistance will increase. And if the cross-sectional area will decrease, then resistance will increase, and the cross-sectional area increase, so resistance will decrease. Okay. It's a type of confusion is happening. Okay, no issues. Well, let's move on. It's the inverse proportion. One increases, the other decreases. Okay, now I had written the mathematical form of this. That is, R is directly proportional to L, R is inversely proportional to A. Combining them, we get R is directly R proportional to L by A. So after that, keeping the constant of proportionality, we get R is equals to rho into L by A. Okay, now another thing we had used here, that is rho. Rho is this symbol rho. Rho is the constant of proportionality. This is our rho, this symbol rho into L by A. R is equal to the formula we had got. R is equal to rho into L by A. So this is rho. See here. Okay. Rho, resistivity of the material of the conductor. This is the constant of proportionality. Okay, now let us discuss some more thing about. I hope so that this is a very easy thing you understood and learn it also. Okay, now coming to some of the points regarding the resistivity. SI unit of rho is ohm meter. Resistivity is a characteristic of the material of the conductor. The order of the conductor, metal and alloys, sorry, the order of the resistivity of the conductor are in the range of 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter to 10 to the power minus 6 ohm meter. It means it is very less. As we can see, the resistivity of the conductors, metals and alloys, are very less. Okay, seeing another thing. As it is written here, another points regarding the resistivity. The order of resistivity of insulator are 10 to the power 17 to 10 to the power, sorry, 10 to the power 12 ohm meter to 10 to the power 17 ohm meter. So this is a very high range value. So it means the resistivity of insulators are very high. Now let's move on. The resistivity of alloy are generally higher than that of its constituent metals, and it does not differ, sorry, it does not oxidize, burn also readily at high temperature. So two characteristics having its resistivity is high in comparison to the its constituent metals, the resistivity of alloys. And another thing which is good in alloys, that they do not burn or oxidize at high temperature readily. That's why they are generally used in electrical heating devices such as electric iron and toaster. So this is one of the answer of your question, that why we use alloys in the electric heaters, electric irons and toasters, etc. Okay, so based on this theory, I had discussed one question with you people so that you can understand, and given some questions in assignments also, in assignment also, for you people to means solve, and so that you get some more ideas about this regarding the topic. Okay, now coming back the question, a 4 ohm resistance wire is doubled on it. Calculate the new resistance of the wire. It's very easy question. It means we had folded the 4 ohm resistance and decreases its length to L by 2, then obviously its cross-sectional area will increase to 2 times. So that I have written as per question information. The new length of the wire will be half of its previous length and its cross-sectional area A gets doubled. Sorry, cross-sectional area gets doubled. It's not A. A is written as small and okay. See, you can see the picture. This is your original length and this is your new one. Okay, so okay, moving on. So let the length we are now we are assuming the length and cross-sectional area of the conductor or the resistor be L and A. So this is the original length and area respectively, and its resistivity we are assuming as ohm. Okay, now moving on. R is equal to rho into L by A. We are knowing the formula is equal to 4 ohm. Continuing with this, new length is equal to L dash and the new area is equal to 2A, that is A dash. New length is equal to L by 2, sorry, the is equal to L dash, we had assumed it, and new area is equal to 2A, that is A dash, we had assumed it. So therefore, new resistance is equal to R dash is equal to rho into L dash divided by A dash. It means in place of the original values L and A, since our values are changing, that's why I had put it L dash and A dash. After that, continuing with that, substitute the values of L dash and A dash. It means we are going to put the values of L dash and A dash. L dash is L by 2 and A dash is 2A. And now after the calculation, you can see the calculations over here. R dash is equal to rho into L by 2 by 1 by 2A. It simply calculated it, so we get R dash is equal to rho L by A 4A. R dash is equal to 1 by 4, separating out rho into L by A. So this rho into L by A we had seen here, the original resistance. So we had replaced this with capital R, and the capital R value is 4. So R dash is equal to 1 by 4 into 4. It means the new resistance R dash is equal to 1 ohm is our answer. I hope so. The things must be clear with you people. So the other things we'll see in the next class. Thank you for today. Thank you, everyone.